So in this video, we are taking up another section from linear algebra, which is QR decomposition of a matrix. I'm hoping that you have already watched LR decomposition of a matrix. So it is slightly different from it, from the one which we discussed in our previous videos. Now here a matrix will be given to you and you have to split it into two parts, Q and R. So what is Q matrix and what is R and how you can decompose or factorize it? This is what we are going to study in this video. So stay tuned with us. Let's see with the help of an example. Matrix and matrix is here. So your first step is, firstly, you should know about the Gram-Schmidt process. So if you haven't watched that video, please go through it, check that out, and then come back to this video. So just like in Gram-Schmidt process, you have to split this matrix into the column vectors. So as you can see, this is a 3x3 order of matrix, 3x3 order matrix. So it will have three columns, obviously. So we are writing down, let's assume that three column vectors are v1, v2, v3. So first column is this, 1, 0, 0. Second column is 0, 2, minus 1. Third column is 2, 0, 1. Right. Now you have to find out orthonormal basis. Orthonormal basis, just like you did it in Gram-Schmidt process. So how you do that? Firstly, to get orthonormal basis, you have to find out orthogonal basis using Gram-Schmidt. So I'm telling you how you can do so. So you, because there are three column vectors, so there will be three orthogonal bases. Let's say y1, y2 and y3. y1 is always equal to the first column vector, which is v1 here, that is 1, 0, 0. Now what about other two, y2 and y3? The formula which Gram-Schmidt says is y2 is equal to v2 minus dot product of v2 y1, then dot product of y1 and its whole dot product with y1. So if we calculate it separately, v2 dot y1 is what? V2 is 0, 2, minus 1 and y1 is this, 1, 0, 0. So do the dot product, 0 into 1 is 0, 2 into 0 is 0, minus 1 into 0 is 0. So this is 0. So we don't need to calculate anything, 0 multiplied with anything is 0. So only v2 is left. Now for y3, what we have as the formula is v3 minus v3 dot v1, v1 dot v1 and its dot product with v1. Minus v3 dot v2 divided by v2 dot v2, its dot product with v2. So here we have v3 as 201 minus v3 dot v1, we can calculate here 201 and v1 is what? 100. So 2 times 1 is 2, rest all will be 0. So this is 2. Correct? Then v1 dot v1 is what? V1 dot V1 is 100 dot 100. So 1 times 1 is 1. Right? So this is 2. This is 1. So 2 by 1 is 2. V1 is 100 minus V3 dot V2 is what? V3 dot V2. V3 is 201 and V2 is 0, 2 minus 1. So this 2 times 2, 0 is 0. 0 times 2 is 0. 1 dot minus 1 is minus 1 and then we have to find out v2 dot v2. So v2 is 0, 2 minus 1, 0, 2 minus 1, 0 times 0 is 0, 2 2 is 4, minus minus plus 1, that is 5. So v3 dot v2 is here, minus 1 divided by v2 dot v2 is 5. And then we have V2, which is 0, 2, minus 1, right? So this forms 201 minus 2, 1 is 2, 0, 0, then minus minus plus 1 by 5. So if you multiply 1 by 5 with 0 is 0, this is 2 by 5, then minus 1 by 5. Correct? Now you have to calculate the rest. What is it? So 2 minus 2 is 0. So first element will be 0. Let me change the pen so that you can clearly see it. 2 minus 2 is 0. So first element is 0. 0 minus 0 is 0. Only 2 by 5 is left. And 1 minus 0 is 1. 1 minus 1 by 5 is 4 by 5. So this is your Y3. Now you have your orthogonal bases. How you will calculate your orthonormal vector? So let me rewrite Y1, Y2, Y3. Y1 is your V1 only, that is 1, 0, 0. Y2 we calculated 0, 2, minus 1. And Y3 we calculated as 0, 2 by 5, 4 by 5. Right? So these are orthogonal bases, right, in the form of Y. Now in order to get orthonormal bases, what you are supposed to do? You have to divide orthogonal bases with the norms. So norm of Y1 will be, it's like modulus. 1 root 1 square plus 0 square plus 0 square. So only 1 will be there. Then for Y2 you have 0 square is 0, 2 square is 4, minus 1 square is 1, so root 5. And for Y3 it is 0 square, 2 by 5 whole square plus 4 by 5 whole square. That is 2 to the 4 by 25, 4 4 to the 16 by 25. 20 by 25, 5 4s are, 5 5s are, 2 by root 5. So just divide, orthonormal bases will be a set of these orthogonal bases divided by their norms, their respective norms. So Y1 divided by modulus of Y1, it is 1 only, so it will be same. So Y2 divided by norm of Y2, that is 1 by root 5, divide it with divide root 5 with all the elements 2 minus 1. I mean divide all elements with root 5. And then for third one we have 2 by root 5, right? So 1 by 2 root 5, 2 by root 5. So root 5 will become numerator. 0, 2 by root 5. This is only 5, right? Let me use eraser. I'm hoping you are getting it, right? 4 by 5. But this is like you have done this question up till Gram-Schmidt process. But now you have to decompose that matrix into QR. Right? So what is Q? Q is basically the matrix form of these orthonormal bases. That is 1, 0, 0. If you divide 1 by root 5 with these, 0. 2 by root 5, minus 1 by root 5. And then this is 0. If you divide 2 by 5 with root 5 by 2, it will be 4 by 5 root 5, right? Just bear with me. It is 2 by root 5, right? So it was 1 by 2 by root 5. So it becomes like this. Okay. So if you just simply multiply this, you have already divided, right? So just multiply 0. Then 2 by 5 into root 5 by 2. This is nothing. So you can split root 5 as root 5 as root 5 into root 5, right? So it is 2 by 2 root 5. Right? Then you have 0 here. Okay, 2 can also be cancelled. Just bear with me. So now here we get 1 by root 5 only, right? Then if you do root 5 by 2, multiply 4 by 5, 2 to the 4, and then 1 root 5, so 2 by root 5. This is your Q. Now you have to find out another matrix, which is R, because of course this is QR decomposition, right? So what is R now? So you calculate R using Q transpose A. Okay? So Q transpose, that means make rows as column 1, 0, 0. Then second row will become second column 2 by root 5, 1 by root 5. And third row will become third column minus 1 by root 5. 2 by root 5. This is your R and this is Q transpose, and A is what? A is your question matrix, which is given in the question. 0, 2, minus 1, 2, 0, 1. Okay, now multiply this. So either what you can do, this is your R matrix, right? First row, first column, multiply. 1 times 1 is 1 and rest will be 0. Then first row, second column, 1 times 0 is 0, 0 times 2 is 0. This is first row, second column is 0. Then first row, third column, 2 times 1 is 2. Rest all will be 0, right? So 1, 0, 2 is your first row. Then second row, first column, this will be 0 only. Second row, second column, so 2 to the 4 by root 5. So 4 by root 5. Minus 1 by root 5 into minus 1 plus 1 by root 5. That means 5 by root 5. That is root 5 only. Correct. Then second row, third column. 0 times 2 is 0. This is 0. Only minus 1 by root 5. Then third row, first column. 0. This will be 0. Then third row, second column. 0 multiply 0 is 0, 1 by root 5 into 2 is 2 by root 5, and 2 by root 5 minus 1, so minus 2 by root 5, that is 0. Then you have third row, third column, 2 times 0 is 0, this is 0, 2 by root 5. So you have Q with you, you have R with you, so QR decomposition will be simply the splitting of A matrix into two matrix, which is Q. Right? 1 by root 5, 2 by root 5, and R. R is what? Here. 1, 0, 0. Let me erase it. So it's like you are decomposing a matrix into two different matrices, which is QR. So R is what? 0, root 5, 0. 2 minus 1 by root 5, 2 by root 5. Okay. So you can see what is Q. Q is basically a matrix which is formed of orthonormal bases. Correct? And what is R? It is kind of upper triangular matrix, right? It is an upper triangular matrix of order n by n. So you can see this is of order m by n because A matrix was of order m by n, and this is a upper triangular matrix, this is of order n by n. So this is how you can split a matrix into Q and R, and this process is called QR decomposition. I'm hoping that you have got this process right, and if so, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel. Till our next video, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.